For hundreds of years, people all over the world have reported sightings of an unknown creature who stalks about the vast, untouched wilderness of the globe. This tall, lumbering, fur-covered being is commonly referred to as Bigfoot or Sasquatch. Its stealthy presence in the deep woods has created a legend throughout time, bringing various groups of believers together in a relentless effort to prove the existence of this elusive creature. Evidence of its existence ranges from blurry film, plaster casts of large footprints, and the occasional scratchy audio of the beast's resonating calls. So what is it that draws people to seek this creature out amongst the deep forests and high mountaintops? Is it the reward of discovery? The allure of an encounter with something which has forever eluded capture? Or is it the fascinating tales of others who became sudden believers after a single spotting of something they couldn't explain? On Tuesday, August 7th, 2018, at around 10 p.m., there was a Sasquatch sighting on the outskirts of a small town in the Adirondacks of upstate New York known as Whitehall. A man who wanted to remain anonymous for fear of ridicule was driving along Route 40 on his way to Vermont when he witnessed something which would change his view of Bigfoot for the rest of his life. According to his story, his headlights came across a 6-foot ape-like creature standing upright, glancing at him, and then it suddenly climbed over the guardrail and disappeared into the woods. This tale brought new hope to a town already obsessed with sightings of a mysterious creature in their midst. Now, remember his description. A 6-foot black, ape-like creature. I assure you it'll be important by the end of this video. The video you're about to see is intended for entertainment purposes only. Thomas and I did not make the video to insult or discount anyone involved with the research or documentation of Sasquatch encounters. We set out to enjoy the weirdness of a town who has for many years embraced the Sasquatch as its town mascot. The first interview we had with a local revealed the truth behind one of the notorious sightings in Whitehall. This will be explained at the very end of this video, so if you'd rather not know what really happened, we recommend you don't watch all the way till the end. Anyways, thanks for watching. We hope you enjoy this short journey with us on another roads less traveled.
Today, folks, on Roads Less Traveled, we're going to be hunting a Sasquatch. Y'all may not know this, but there's a Sasquatch in upstate New York, a small little hamlet called Whitehall. He's going to find that Sasquatch.
Yeah, we are.
Hunt him down.
Yeah. Ain't nothing going to stop us.
On a day like today, your time is numbered, Sasquatch. We's coming for you. We know how to hunt Sasquatch from South Dakota. He's gonna find you. That's why you don't hear about Sasquatch in South Dakota, because we done hunt them all. We're gonna bring your pelt home and hang it above our balcony.
There we is, Sasquatch. This is premium Sasquatch camouflage. It protects your smell from him. You put it on just like so, and then you cover up your face with it so that he can't smell your stinky breath. Now, if you're like me, you haven't brushed your teeth in a couple of years. Now, also this protects against his mink.
They do smell.
Yeah, they do smell. They do not smell good. So if you have this on, you can't smell his feces. It stinks a lot, so we kind of need these.
People of Whitehall, New York are very passionate about their Sasquatch. They've even dubbed this master of hide-and-seek as their town animal. Anyone visiting the small town will witness various metal statues strewn all over town depicting this larger-than-life beast. Every September, the town of Whitehall holds an annual Sasquatch festival. The festival is complete with a contest in which people try out their best Sasquatch calls for a multitude of prizes. There is a history here, one which from some brings chuckles and others stories of sightings. You may see people comparing large footprints cast in the mud, or even an occasional trail camera footage capturing the larger-than-life beast stealing their apples. However, whatever the reason may be, the town of Whitehall shares its spirited weirdness with the world and continues a decades-long hunt for its beloved Bigfoot.
Alright folks, as you can see, we've done found Bigfoot.
Yeah, he's right here.
He's right here.
Yeah.
We found all sorts of his brothers and kin there in the town of Whitehall.
Well, this here's the original one.
I think this is the Papa.
Yeah.
The Papa Bigfoot right here. You can tell by them sinister red eyes he's got.
You see these red eyes?
See that?
Yeah.
And he's kind of holding a flag here.
It's like he's claimed it.
Like he's the one that's...
Yeah.
That's claimed all of Whitehall. So, you look around, you find them Sasquatches. They're out there.
They're out there. Here's
they're out there. Out there in the woods. You listen real good, you can hear. I'd say they're coming for us. Better get out of here.
Yeah.
They don't like us messing with us, Papa. All right, we're just gonna leave nice and slow. Nice and slow. I don't like the way he's looking at me. He's eyeballing me awful weird. right, we're leaving Bigfoot. I don't like the way he's looking at him, but I think maybe some of them of his kin is coming around. We best get out of here now.
So, while Thomas and I were beginning our interview process in the town of Whitehall of its local residents concerning the Bigfoot mystery, we ran into a young fellow in this shop here. The story he told us immediately ceased any further interviews we might have decided to have that day. What the man told us was just this. The creature which was spotted in that late night in 2018 was actually a friend of his dressed in an ape suit. He said his friend had had the ape suit since the late 50s and had used it a few times before in the mid to late 70s to scare people as a joke. On that night, when that car's headlights crossed the ape-like figure jumping over the guardrail, it was this young man's friend playing a drunken prank. There had been a party that evening, and somebody said, "Hey, why don't you put on the ape suit and go scare people driving down the road?" So sure enough, the ape suit was taken out of the back of an old car parked in a garage. The elderly man had put it on and decided to go play a prank on people driving down Route 40. So this is it. This is the story of Bigfoot. While maybe not all sightings are somebody dressed in an ape suit, this certainly was. I'm sorry to have to reveal this and take away some of the magic, but I thought it only fair that people know not every encounter with Bigfoot is a true encounter with Bigfoot.